Hey everyone, you are watching Biology with Inshara, and in today's video we are going to continue from where we last left off. Now in the first video, in the part one of the video cell which I made, we spoke about the different types of cells and the different organelles found in a cell. And now in the part two of the video that you're watching right now, we're going to talk about the organization of life. Stay here, don't go anywhere, because we're going to complete the full chapter by the end of the video. Now if you look on the screen, you will find the definitions of the different organelles that are found in both an animal cell and a plant cell, and you will see that the function of those organelles has been written down for your ease. And in the next slide after this slide, I've written down the organelles that are only found in a plant cell and their respective functions in quite a lot of detail. And I'm sure that even after watching cell part one and going through the two slides, it should be more than enough for you guys to understand the types of cells and the types of different organelles that are found in both an animal cell and a plant cell, and also some of the different organelles found in a plant cell and not in an animal cell, including their functions and what those organelles do. Now in the next part, which is going to start now, we're going to talk about the last section of this chapter, which is called as the organization of life, which is very simple. However, you need to understand it with a few examples which I'm going to give. Okay, now in front of you on your screen is a picture. Now the picture is the organization of life. Now in order to explain what the organization of life is, you must first understand what is a cell. And of course, I have already talked about this in part one. However, just to give you a recap, cell is the basic unit of life or the basic building block of life. Now, let's talk about this with logic. Now, we humans are made up of cell, and then we also have organs, and then we have tissue. So what are they made up of? Now, that's where the concept called organization of life comes in. To elaborate, we know that according to biology and from thorough research done by many renowned scientists, that cells with similar structures, or when similar cells combine together, they form a tissue. Now the types of cells would be the animal cell and the plant cell, just to give you guys an example. And tissues are made up of cells, similar types of cells. And to give you an example of tissues in animals, we have the muscular tissue, the nervous tissue, and in plants we have the mesophyll tissue. Now those cells can either be the same or different. If they're the same, we call it a simple tissue, like the muscular tissue is only made up of muscle cells. And if those cells are different, then we call it a complex tissue. Now the mesophyll cell in the leaf of a plant has the palisade cell and the spongy layer cell. So that's why we call it a complex tissue. Moving on, we then know that when different tissues combine together, they form an organ. Now this, in this case here, the tissues have to be different. It's not that the tissues can be the same. No, they have to be different. So when different tissues combine together, they form an organ. Okay, now the examples of organs are pretty obvious. We have the lung, we have the stomach, we have the heart, right? Now just to elaborate on this, let me give you an example. Now let's take the stomach as an example, and the stomach is made up of three different types of tissues, starting out with the muscular tissue and the nervous tissue and the gland tissue. Now the muscular tissue's job is to churn the food. It physically moves around to churn the food. And then we have the gland tissue, which actually makes the digestive enzymes. And then we have the nervous tissue, which actually gives instructions to the gland tissue to make enzymes when food is in the stomach and is ready for digestion. Now those different tissues work together for a specific task. Okay, moving on, different and various types of organs work together for a common purpose to achieve a specific task. For example, let me give you an organ system example. We have the digestive system, and there are several different organs working together for a common purpose, which in the case here is to digest your food and absorb the nutrients so that it can be used by your body cells. Now in the digestive system, we have the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine, the rectum, and they're all working together for a common one purpose, which is to digest your food and to absorb it, which mainly occurs in the small intestine. Now, we will be covering this chapter very soon on digestion in great detail, so don't worry about that. But for now, just understand that the different organs work together for a common purpose, enabling an organ system. And there are different types of organ systems, right? After the organs working together for a common purpose, we then have the organ system. And examples of some of the organ systems would be the digestive system, the excretory system, the circulatory system, and then we also have the reproductive system. Now, in the excretory system, we have the kidneys working with the ureters to remove nitrogenous waste in your urine. Okay, and then we have the circulatory system, in which the heart pumps blood around your body to distribute oxygen and food in your blood to the different cells so that they can be used for the process called respiration, by which energy is made in the form of ATP. We will be covering that as well, but for now, just understand this for the sake of simplicity. I won't be getting into much detail, as our main focus is on organization of life. But just look at the amazingness of this, how cells combine to form tissues, and then how tissues combine to form organs, and how different organs work together for a common purpose, thus forming an organ system, and how different and various organ systems, which I've given a few examples, work together to keep both you and me alive. Because without those organ systems, we humans would be nothing, okay? Well, that's pretty much it. So we have successfully completed the chapter cell, including the different organelles and the organization of life. Now, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you are watching this on YouTube, then don't forget to hit that like and notification bell button, and do leave a comment down below and subscribe for weekly content, and do check out my Facebook page, and the link is down below. Now, if you're watching this on Facebook, then go check out my YouTube channel. The link is down below, and like and follow my page, and I will be uploading weekly content for you guys. You guys may leave a comment if you want to cover a specific topic, or I may even answer your questions on biology if you have. I will be doing a Q&A session for you, those who have questions. But for now, do subscribe, do like, and do follow. See you next week. Hey everyone, you are watching Biology.